Hello everyone and welcome back to Scandinavian Design 101. I'm Sanna.
I'm Andreas and we're two Swedes and we love design. Mm-hmm. And today we're going to talk about the Danish furniture designer Børge Mogensen. His high quality furniture with clean lines and often fair price gave him the nickname the People's Designer. Mm-hmm. In a way, he personifies Danish modern more than any other architect. We also want to recommend a fantastic book about Mogensen called Børge Mogensen, Simplicity and Function. And it's written in English and it gives you a lot of information as well as wonderful pictures.
Yeah. Børge Vestergaard Mogensen was born in April of 1914 in the Danish town of Aalborg. His mother Else was a housewife and his father Nils was a tile manufacturer. Börje had two siblings, the older brother Harald and the younger sister Agnete. Nils earned just enough money to provide for the family that lived in an apartment in the central part of town. As a child, Börje didn't like being forced to go to school, but who did? Reading and theoretical knowledge just wasn't right for him, and he also hated going to church. Instead of sitting still in a school or church bench, he loved working with his hands and soon found an interest in woodworking. He wanted to become a carpenter and at the age of 16 in 1930, he got an apprenticeship at the local wood workshop. One of the first products Börje learned to produce was coffins, then delivered to the local funeral homes. After working 4 years at the workshop, he moved to Copenhagen to study at the School of Arts and Crafts and somewhat later at the Royal Academy of Fine Art. In school, the students learned to paint in watercolor and design things like patterns for wallpapers before starting the actual furniture program. One of his classmates was Hans J Wegner, and the two would become friends for the rest of their lives. Parallel with studies, Börje also worked extra in the workshop of the legendary designer Mogens...
Kock, I think.
Oh. Okay.
During studies, he also came in contact with the father of Danish modern, Kaare Klint, who was a professor at the Royal Academy. From him, Börje learned to create furniture adapted for the human body using simple and strong constructions. In contrast to most modernists, Klint didn't want to create new shapes, rather develop and refine traditional furniture types. This idea would come to influence not just Mogensen, but almost the whole Danish design scene. Already in 1939, Mogensen exhibited furniture for the first time at the annual Copenhagen Cabinet Makers Guilds exhibition, showing furniture created in the manner of Klint. Especially interesting was the multifunctional furniture he designed to be used in student dormitories. During his career, Mogensen would come to attend the Cabinet Makers Guild's exhibition 26 times, and we will get back to this later. Early in his career, Mogensen created highly traditional and robust furniture, and this would in a different extent follow him for the rest of his life. The furniture weren't made to be exclusive or end up in some random museum. Instead, they should be functional and simple without unnecessary decorations or complicated constructions. He criticized colleagues like Finjul and Hans Wegner for making too complicated and artistic furniture not adapted for their use.
We just said they were friends.
Yeah, they were, but he also criticized him all the time.
That's kind of rude.
Yeah.
In 1942, Mogensen married the seamstress Alice Klyverkron and moved to a small functionalist apartment in the Copenhagen district of Frederiksberg. Soon the son Peter was born, followed a couple years later by the second son Thomas. Also in 1942, Mogensen was hired as head of the furniture department FDB.
Yeah.
Yeah. The Danish Consumer Cooperative Society. Yeah, I don't know why that was
name.
Hard to say, but yeah. Their aim was to offer modern and functional furniture to the public for a reasonable price. This suited the young Mogensen perfectly, who immediately started designing a range of furniture suited for industrial mass production. With these new furniture, FDB wanted to make it possible also for the middle class to furnish their homes with modern and functional furniture. Only the upper class had until then been able to afford the exclusive modernist furniture like those exhibited at the cabinet makers' exhibitions. In 1944, Mogensen exhibited his first complete range of furniture for FDB at a brand new store in Copenhagen. The customers were encouraged to mix the different pieces as desired. I like that.
Yeah.
Previously, furniture had often been sold in complete sets, but now the buyers could choose the exact pieces they wanted. As a result, the customer didn't have to spend a lot of money at the same time. One could start buying the most necessary and then complete the furniture later on. Even though the birchwood furniture FDB couldn't be compared with the high-end furniture producers by master cabinet makers, they were still of great quality, not least compared with other furniture at the same price range.
Yeah. When FDB released their furniture in 1944, they spent a lot of money on marketing, but convincing the general public of buying modernist furniture turned out to be far from easy. Furniture stores were opened all over Denmark, but the consumers were skeptic. The Danish population turned out to be quite traditional and didn't understand why they should pay good money for simple-looking furniture when they could get decorated and extravagant-looking items for the same price. Mm-hmm. Not until a favorable credit was offered in 1948, the sales started rising. Mogensen continued designing new furniture for FDB for the rest of the 40s, and he also involved famous colleagues like Hans Wegner, who designed the classic rocking chair J16, among other things.
Did they like each other? Didn't they like
it? Well, a bit unclear. Nowadays, Mogensen is highly associated with shaker-style furniture, a type of functional furniture he started designing for FDB in the 40s. The best-known example is probably the chair J39 and the table C18, designed in 1947. And the Shakers, they were a Christian sect founded in England in the 1740s and then organized in the United States a couple of decades later. And they got their name because of their ecstatic behavior while praying, the Shakers.
Yeah. I get it.
The sect designed their own furniture and believed that making something well was in itself an act of prayer. Their furniture weren't decorated like all other furniture at the time, but instead fully adapted for their use. And in a way, this was functionalism way before its time. Inexpensive wood like pine was used, and this resulted in pieces light in color as well as weight. And it's not hard to understand why Mogensen was fascinated by the shaker furniture. And in a way, the J39 chair was a combination between a traditional shaker chair and the shirt chair designed by Kaare Klint already in the 1930s. And now, let's take a look at some of the other furniture designed by Mogensen for FDB.
As head of FDB furniture department, Mogensen designed a huge lot of furniture, but sales never really gained momentum. He accused the company of mismanaging the marketing campaigns. When a new director of FDB was hired in 1950, the conflict between Mogensen and the company culminated. In the middle of a meeting, Mogensen rose from the conference table, left the building, never to come back again. The 8 years he had worked at FDB was a highly important time for Mogensen, who had learned a lot about furniture design in practice. When he first came to the company in 1942, he was a young and inexperienced designer. When he left, he was one of the shooting stars on the Danish design scene.
Yes, and yeah, this was our first video about Börje Mogensen, and we will continue already next Sunday talking about the later half of his career.
Yeah.
And if you like this video,
please click thumbs up and subscribe.
Yeah, and follow us on Instagram, we're called Scandinavian Design 101.
Yeah, thank you for watching.
Thanks.